My name is Bob Scott. I'm an extension weed scientist with the University of Arkansas's Division of Agriculture Cooperative Extension Service, and I'd like to talk to you today about a little bit of the work that we're currently conducting at the Rice Research and Extension Center here at Stuttgart, Arkansas. The trial that we're standing in right now is a long-term rotational study looking at the effects of continuous Clearfield rice on red rice populations. Clearfield rice currently makes up around 60 to 70% of the rice acres grown here in Arkansas. We have a concern that the overuse or continued use of this technology since its introduction in 2002 may be leading to the development of resistant red rice populations. The objective of this study is to evaluate a number of rotational strategies, everything from continuous Clearfield rice using nothing but ALS, technology, all the way up to a couple of years of fallow following a full infestation of red rice. This study also includes rotations with Liberty Link and Roundup Ready soybeans. To date, we have determined that we do in fact see a buildup of red rice when we go continuous Clearfield rice. By simply delaying the planting date in a continuous rice system, we have reduced red rice populations by as much as 60 to 70%. We have also shown in this study that by rotating to Roundup Ready or Liberty Link soybeans, or by conducting 1 year of fallow, that is laying a field out and preventing any red rice from germinating, that we have effectively reduced red rice populations up to 80 or 90%. This is the second year of a three-year study. Next year, this entire area will be planted back to Clearfield rice so we can determine after 3 years of various rotation strategies which ones are the most effective at reducing red rice populations compared to continuous Clearfield rice production. In order to initiate this study in year one, this entire field that I'm standing in was allowed to go to seed. It was in a completely grown up in red rice. It also had some volunteer Clearfield rice in it. So that's how we established this area in a known red rice infested field. The actual plot I'm standing in is plot number one. In year one, this entire treatment was Clearfield rice with nothing but new path followed by new path. This year, in year two of the rotational study, we drug a levee down the center of the plot. As you can see, we've rotated half the plot to soybeans. The other half remains in a continuous Clearfield system. Further up in this tier is an untreated check, which gives us an idea of the red rice populations that we continue to deal with in this field. As you can see, our soybean treatment is providing excellent control of red rice. We have detected a few red rice plants escaping in the continuous Clearfield rice system. Another area of research that we have here at the Rice Research and Extension Center at Stuttgart, Arkansas, is in the area of barnyard grass. Barnyard grass continues to be the number one weed control problem in rice. Since the introduction of Clearfield rice in 2002, we've really had no new chemistry to combat barnyard grass in rice production fields. Command continues to be the foundation in both conventional and Clearfield rice for the control of barnyard grass. As a service to the growers here in Arkansas, Dr. Jason Norsworthy, my research counterpart in Fayetteville, conducts annual surveys of barnyard grass resistance in the state of Arkansas. These samples are sent in by county agents from all over the state. We bring those samples here to Stuttgart to conduct research on both the control, biology, and ecology of these weeds. The research conducted here for barnyard grass, because we have no new chemistry, simply involves taking a population of barnyard grass that's, say, resistant to propanil, and then building a weed control program around the control of this pest in the absence of propanil. To date, we have detected propanil, facet, command, and new path resistant barnyard grass, which leaves us with only a few modes of action left for the control of this weed, should it ever become that all populations are resistant to those families of chemistry. The research conducted here in Stuttgart at the Rice Research and Extension Center will help provide growers in the future with ways to control this number one pest in rice. Another area of research that we are conducting here at the Rice Research and Extension Center is looking at pigweed control on rice levees. Glyphosate-resistant Palmer amaranth or Palmer pigweed has become a major problem throughout the state. Rice rotation is a good cultural practice for the control of this pest in other crops such as corn, cotton, and soybeans. However, in certain counties in Arkansas, the application of 2,4-D has been restricted after April 15th. 2,4-D is the most effective pigweed treatment that we currently have in rice, but for those areas that are too close to cotton or other sensitive crops or that are in the restricted counties, they don't have the 2,4-D option to use on levees. In this particular study, we're evaluating various other treatments for the control of pigweed and other broadleaf weeds on rice levees in Arkansas. Let's go over now and take a look at one of our more effective program approaches for pigweed and broadleaf weed control on levees. In those areas where 2,4-D is not an option, a planned program approach for Palmer amaranth is a much better option than trying to wait and go post-emerge. Late post applications of products like AIM and propanil or grandstand and propanil are effective at controlling smaller 2 to 4 inch Palmer amaranth. Anything that gets any bigger than that is where we used to rely on 2,4-D for control, which we no longer have in some cases. The plot that I'm standing in front of right here received a pre-flood application of prowl and facet, followed by an early post levee application of grandstand and permit. And this planned approach applied to this levee has provided effective pigweed and broadleaf weed control, as you can see. Since the introduction of herbicide-tolerant crops, misapplication and herbicide drift have been a common problem throughout the state. The University of Arkansas is sponsoring a program called Flag the Technology that will hopefully alleviate some of the problems with identifying fields according to the herbicides in which will tolerate them. Flag the Technology was initiated this year in 2011, and we have seen rapid adoption. The flag colors are red for conventional, white for Roundup Ready, green for Liberty Link, and yellow for the Clearfield technology. By placing a flag with the appropriate color in the corner of a field, a grower can identify that field according to its herbicide technology. Our hope at the university is this will help prevent the misapplication of herbicides or the drift of herbicides onto these fields, thereby improving crop production.
To learn more about this and other topics, contact your county extension agent and visit uaex.edu.